Hello students, today we will discuss the important mathematics for subtraction. Okay, subtraction is nothing but let me say, take some example. Suppose I have 10 chocolate. Okay, I have 10 chocolate. I will give 5 chocolate to you. So how many chocolate left with me? Okay, I have 10 chocolate. I will give 5 chocolate to you. So remaining, how much chocolate left with me? How you will find out? So 10 minus 5, 5. So 5 is the 5 chocolate left with me. So this kind of calculation in our daily life we will do. Okay. So in mathematically, they have some procedure before going subtraction. They have some procedure. We will see one by one, step by step, what is the procedure that they are in subtraction. Okay, let me see. When you do subtraction, you may use this symbol. The symbol we use in subtraction, minus symbol, the name minus. First procedure. Okay, the second one, the number from which a number. From which a number subtracted is called minuend. Minuend. Okay. Then second one, the number that is subtracted is called subtrahend. The number that is subtracted, it is called subtrahend. Okay. So the answer we get, it is called difference. So these three, four important procedure we want to know before going to subtraction sums. So minus, when we subtract sum, we will use this symbol. Then minuend, which number we have subtracted from the number is called minuend. Which number subtracted is called subtrahend. The answer is difference. Okay. Okay. Let me see some example. Okay. Let me assume I have 48 pence. Okay, I will give 38 pence to others. Now, how much pen left with me? How to find out? I have 48 pence. I give 38 to others. So, how much remain? How much pen left with me? How to find out? Let me do simple calculation. So, 48, which number from subtracted, that number is called minuend. Which number is subtracted, it is called subtrahend. So the answer is difference. So as per the properties or subtraction properties, 48 is the minuend. Okay. Okay, as per the property, 38 is the subtrahend. Subtrahend. Okay, now we find out the answer. So 8 minus 8, 0. 8 minus 8, 0. 4 minus 3, 1. So how much pen remained left with me? 10 pence left with me. Okay, this is the answer. It's called, we call difference. So this is the minuend, it's a subtrahend, the answer result is difference. These three important properties are called subtraction properties. Okay. Okay students, let me see some example sum. Okay, subtraction sum. It's a 5-digit number. Okay. So before doing subtraction, you need to form the table. Place a new table because it is easy for doing addition or subtraction any. So before that I have made this table. So how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s, 10,000. So totally 10,000 place. So 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s, 10,000 place. I have formed this table. Now I will place from this number to this number. So it's a minuend. It's a subtrahend. So first I will place the minihin. Which is the minihin? This is the minihin. So 8, 5, 5, 5, 5. So 8 is the ones place. This 5 times place, 100 place, 1000, 10,000 place. Okay, we place it. Now we have to place subtrahend. Subtrahend always relates right to left. So 8 is the ones place, 4 is the times place, 3 is the 100 place, 2 is 1000 place, 1 is 10,000 place. Now we want to subtract. Okay, now we want to find out the difference. So it's a minihin, you know very well. Okay, whenever you do this calculation, you have to mark it like this minihin. It's a minihin. It's a minihin, it's a subtrahend. Okay, so repeatedly when you write, easily you can remember these words, minihin, subtrahend, difference. Okay, so it's very important words, properties in this mathematicals, subtraction or addition, whatever may be. It's a important properties, minihin, subtrahend, multiplication. So we will see one by one properties, but this subtraction sum is these three properties are very important properties. Minihin, subtrahend, difference. Okay, it's very important properties. Now we will subtract. First we have to start always right to left. So 8 minus 8, we know it's a 0. 8 minus 8, 0. First we subtract 1's place. Next 10th place. So 5 minus 4, minihin 5, subtrahend 4. So 5 minus 4, 1. Answer is 1. Then next 100 place, 5 minus 3, minihin is 5, subtrahend is 3. So 5 minus 3, 2 is the difference. The 1000 place, so 5 minus 2, minihin 5, subtrahend 2. 5 minus 2, 3 is the difference. Now 10,000 place, 5 is a minihin, 1 is a subtrahend. So 5 minus 4, say 5 minus 1, 4. 4 is the difference. So what we call the answer is difference. It's very important when you do this calculation, subtraction. Okay, you have to mention that it's a minihin, it's a subtrahend, it's a difference. So when you repeatedly do this, when we write this properties name, you can easily memorize in your mind. Okay. Okay students, let me see the second example. Okay, it's a 5 digit number. Now we will subtract. First of all, I form the place value table. Okay, so now I will place the value. So first I will place this value. It's a minuend. Okay, it's a minuend. So I will place the value 5, 8, 4, 5, 6. So now subtract 7, 1, 5, 4, 3. So it's a minihin, it's a subtrahend. Now we are going to subtract. Whenever you do the sum, you just mark it's a minihin, it's a subtrahend. When you find the answer, it's a difference. You have to mark in your notebook. Okay. Now we will subtract. First we will subtract 1's place. Okay. See, now minihin is smaller than subtrahend. Now shall we? Is it possible to subtract? Is it possible to subtract? No, because minihin always bigger than the minihin, subtrahend. We can easily subtract. Don't confuse. Minihin always bigger than the subtrahend. No need to borrow from other side. But when minihin is smaller than the subtrahend, we need to borrow. Otherwise, we cannot subtract. What I'm telling you to understand, na? Minahan. So it means minahan. The top of the value, always bigger value means no need to borrow that side. But if compare than minahan, subtrahan, it's a smaller than this minahan. So we need to borrow near the number. So now 5 minus 7, we cannot subtract. So what we will do? We need to borrow near the number. So from 8 to, we need to borrow. So after borrowing, the number change 15. Here become a 7. What happened here, you understand, na? Before it was 8. Okay, now I gave one borrow from here to here. So that's why it becomes 7. But here, before it was 5, now 15. Become 15. Now minahan is big number than subtrahend. So now we can subtract. So 15 minus 7, 8. 15 minus 7, 8. Yes, na? So now we can subtract. 8. Now 7 minus 1, we can subtract because minahan is big value, subtract is small value. We can subtract. So 7 minus 1, 6. Now see, again same problem. Minahan is smaller than the subtrahend. So what we have to do? Again we have to borrow the near number. So near number what is 5? So if you give one number, what here will happen? Here it will 4, but here 14. Now 14, minahan is big number than subtrahend. Now we can easily subtract. So 14 minus 5, what? 14 minus 5, 9. Okay, 14 minus 5, 9. 9 is the difference. Okay, now see, 4 minus 4, 0. Easily, you can see. Now, minahan 6, subtrahend 3. We can easily subtract. So 6 minus 3, 3. Now see, now how we can read 1's, 10's, 100, 1000, 10,000, 30,968 is the difference. So every time you have to mark it, it's a difference, it's a subtrahend, it's a minahan. So you always mark these properties, okay?